Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. So as you can see by the title, we have reached this point together. I have three other Girl Talk videos in this series. I will link them down below, and also I'll just link them right here, down the side here. So the top one is about periods, the middle one's about birth control, and the one down here is about like hygiene, shaving, waxing. But today I'm doing the sex one. Now, I think this will probably be two parts. And the reason why is because there's just so much information, which means that there's so much information that can be forgotten, and I just know I'm gonna forget a lot. I did write down some notes, just like a bullet point things that I need to be like, ding, yes, okay, mention that. But sex is just so much more than sex. There's just so many tiers to it. If you have a question about sex that I forget to mention in this video, or a topic that I forgot, leave it down below and I will do a part two. But if this is okay, also let me know down below. Sex is very broad. What does sex even mean? First of all, there's more than just one kind. There's oral sex. Oral sex means mouth, so licking and sucking. Straight sex, which is a man and a woman, and you have a penis and a vagina, a hole and a stick, and it just goes in. That's sex for straight couples. Now, there's also gay sex. Now, I wanted to mention this just because I don't want people to think that straight sex is the only sex, or maybe you are sexually curious. I just don't want to leave anyone out, so I'm gonna just talk about what they are. Gay sex, as in two men, they have a mouth, which is only called oral sex, and then they don't have a vagina, so the only hole they have is a butt. So they do anal sex. Lesbian couples, so that's two females, they obviously both have vaginas and no one has a stick, a penis. So they can use strap-ons, which are dildos, or not. There's also anal sex. So everyone has a butt, whether you are male or female or any of the other sexualities that you want to be called. All of us have a butt. So all of us can do anal sex. It's not just sex, and this is where so many tiers and layers come into this topic. First of all, for women, studies have shown that having sex is the most vulnerable and intimate thing you can do, which is why we get attached. And not only that, but it's the only way to reproduce, to have children, to have babies. Only a man and a woman can reproduce. A man and a man cannot reproduce. A woman and a woman cannot reproduce. And you can also not get pregnant if you have anal sex. But if you are doing anal sex, make sure to wear protection, not for pregnancy, but for STDs. Also, if you did not know, condoms do not protect against all STDs. Some of them, you don't even know it. A lot of people are like, I'm pretty sure I would know. Not true. Back to reproduction. Sorry, this is going to be a little bit all over the place, I think. So reproduction, you need a man and a woman to reproduce. And obviously this is going to depend, because what if they have changed genders and they identify as a man and they were a woman, or a woman and a man? It doesn't matter. Still, one of them has to have a penis and one of them has to have a vagina. Now people have sex just to have sex, just for fun and pleasure. That's another reason why people have sex. And I mean, now we're in 2016, where it's not overly taboo, and all that, and if you want to wait till marriage, that's fine. If you don't, that's fine too. It's completely your decision. I've heard people use Ziploc bags and plastic bags as a condom. What? There's condoms for a reason. Like, if you need a condom, buy a condom. I've heard some people will double up their condoms to be extra protected. Okay, so that basically means that some people will wear two condoms instead of one. That's even worse than wearing one condom. That doesn't give you more protection. And then also I've heard that people using baby oil and Vaseline as lube. Again, we have lube available. I think K&Y is like the Walmart brand. Don't be using Vaseline. You cannot use Vaseline on a latex condom. Next, I want to talk about how important it is to talk with your partner about what you want. Past relationship, for me, my experience, when I lost my virginity, I had three criterias that I needed. I absolutely 100% needed, and they were not questionable. I really wanted to be in a relationship with someone. No, I'm not talking about like a week, a month, and then it was like, okay, like we're ready. No, like an actual relationship, which also goes on to my next criteria that I needed, was I wanted to have a mutual respect and caring. I wanted them to care about me. I did not want it to be like this hookup situation. If you don't know what a hookup means, it basically means like a one night stand, a one time thing. We're gonna do it and I'll never see you again. I did not want that. I just wanted to have feelings for them. I wanted to care about them. I wanted to be like, I could be with you for a while. You know what I mean? So that was something that I also needed. And then the third and final thing that I needed was I also really wanted to lose my virginity to another virgin. And all three happened for me. I'm gonna go into the questions that I asked you guys to ask me. Now again, I definitely feel like that was super, super short. It was very broad. I need to make like a stepping stone for this video, just because there's so many things I could talk about, but just because there's so many things, it's just like I have no idea even where to begin. I'm a little overwhelmed about this sex edition. So these questions I'm gonna leave anonymous. The first question, do you have to have sex to get a baby? Okay, so the answer is yes and no. They don't need to ejaculate in you. They can ejaculate near the area and you can still get pregnant. When is the right age for sex? This is one of those questions where I can't answer. It just depends on you. Just know the risks. Know about pregnancy and STDs. Do research. And again, like, I hope these videos help, but I cannot tell you the age because everyone's different. I think it's perfectly fine to lose your virginity whenever you want. If you're ready at 18, cool. If you're ready at 48, that's cool too. It's just whenever, and that's just how it is. When is it too much? Again, totally personal preference. When is it too much for you is the real question. Period sex. If you refer to my period video, I mentioned like the flow and everything. Period sex actually isn't that bad because, again, it's not a continuous stream of blood. You're not bleeding 24/7. You just get these little rushes of blood. So I wouldn't worry too much about it. I haven't had sex on like my full period. Usually it's like early or the end. But if it's not what you want, then just don't do it. Not a big deal. Next question, is it true that you bleed the very first time? It depends. It depends on you. For me, I think I might have got like 3 drops or something. Nothing too crazy. I know some other people who have bled a little bit longer. It shouldn't be like a period though. It's not like a period blood. It's just like a little. It might be over the course of like a day or two, but it shouldn't be as a period. It should be more of like spotting and things like that. Also, what I want to add to that question, it's not just limited to the one time. It could be the first couple times, or it could be 5, 10, 50 years down the line. It just depends on size, roughness, pace, are you sexually aroused 100%, all that stuff. Does it hurt the first time? Totally depends. I think most people, it does. But also, again, what I want to add to that question is, does it hurt the first time? I'm not going to lie to you here. It pretty much feels the same every single time you do it. For the first few minutes, it's usually like a little uncomfortable and like kind of a little painful sometimes, especially if you're not 100% sexually aroused. So if you need to throw in some lube in there, do that. This question was asked by a boy. I don't have a penis, so I can't really answer you 100%, but I will try. So, do boys get boners? Yes. The way that you have sex is the male has to have a boner. I'm gonna leave pictures, I think, somewhere just so that we understand. A limp penis is their natural state. It's what a penis actually looks like day to day. It's usually a couple inches long. When men get sexually aroused, it turns into a boner. So now it can actually enter the vagina and penetrate. Penetrate means like the motion of in and out. Will it hurt? I don't think it should hurt. Does it feel weird? I'm assuming for the first couple times when you're going through puberty, it might be a little strange. I'm sure that it will just become second nature though. Just as we women have boobs, it's like we don't have them for 13, 14, 15 years, and then all of a sudden we're growing boobs, and it's just like, oh my god. But then you just get used to them. So I think it's just a thing of you'll get used to it. So that's actually all the questions I got, unfortunately. So now I am gonna go into some like most frequently asked questions. I just googled some. So here we go. Can I get pregnant the first time I have sex? Yes! Yes, you can. It doesn't matter if it's the first time or the 500th time. Numbers don't matter in this case. It's literally like, if you have a sperm and an egg, and even if it's the first time, it can happen. I actually got another question. I think that they deleted it, unfortunately, but it was a really, really, really good question, and I'm actually going to answer because I do remember it. So the question was, what if he doesn't want to wear a condom? So I just switched to my phone because my camera died, and I have a lot more talking to do, so bear with me, I'm sorry. When I talked about it's important to talk to your partner, it's just like one of your rules. If that's one of your rules, it's one of your rules. You know, there's no question, there should be no discussion. I'm actually going to tell a little bit of a story. I can totally relate to this question. I was in a relationship, and within a couple months, he was asking me, like, why do we have to use them? Like, can we not? Blah, blah, blah. Really? Like, oh, like, it feels so much better without it. Lie. Google it. Studies have now shown that there is no difference between feeling whether you're using a condom or not. So just tell that bitch, bye. Bye. Like, if you can't respect a very, very simple, common thing that will protect both of you, then fuck off. So just stand up for yourself. It becomes a lot worse when you are actually dating the person who is trying to manipulate you into not using one. Like, they even have a bigger reason to go fuck themselves, because like, you're supposed to care about me. At what age is a guy able to get a girl pregnant? Boys are born already with semen. So they are able to get you pregnant the second they're born. The second. If a guy is a virgin, can he get me pregnant? Yes. Virginity just means that you have not had sex yet. At what age do I start using birth control when having sex. I personally think that once you start thinking about having sex, if you want something more than the condom, then I think that's something that you need to get on before you start having sex. If the girl doesn't have an orgasm, can she still get pregnant? So if you don't know what an orgasm is, it just, like, an orgasm for a male is ejaculating, and for a female it is coming, squirting. An orgasm is just like an immense amount of pleasure. Yes, most women do not have an orgasm just on penetration alone. Again, penetration is just the motion of in and out. So orgasm has nothing to do with pregnancy. Do you see what I mean? Like, there's so many different tiers to sex. Like, there's the orgasm and pregnancy and oral sex and all this stuff, where even though they're all related to each other, they don't actually have, like, relation together. You know, like, orgasm and pregnancy, they're to do with sex, but they have nothing to do with each other. Can I get pregnant from giving oral sex? No. Can I get pregnant from receiving oral sex? No, but both of them, you can still get sexually transmitted diseases. It doesn't all need to be downtown. If they have an STD and you're mouthing it, it's still the same thing as hopping on it. Is there a position where we can have sex that will guarantee I won't get pregnant? No. There, it does not exist. Is it true that you can't get pregnant if you have sex in water? Not true. You can still get pregnant. If I douche right after having sex, will it prevent pregnancy? No. Also, I don't really recommend douching. Sexually not good for you. We have vaginas, they're self-cleaning. Like, how magical is that? Obviously, take a shower still. Douching means, like, washing the inside, like sticking something up there and washing it inside. You don't need to do that. If I have sex on my period, am I safe from pregnancy? Are on your period having sex or before your very first period, you can still get pregnant. You just need to be ovulating, which is the releasing of the egg. If I pee right after sex, will it prevent pregnancy? No. Can I really break his penis? No, there's no bone. I know it's called a boner, but there's actually no bone in a penis. It's literally just like so much blood. That's what it is. So you can't break a penis. You can actually fracture a penis. What should I do if the condom comes off inside me? It's not gonna go anywhere. There's no, like, lost black hole up there. And your cervix is closed. Your cervix is the part... I'll put a picture. The cervix is the part right before your uterus, and unless you're giving birth, that's not open, so it can't go anywhere. So all you need to do is just grab your fingers, and if you need a mirror, take a mirror and just kind of fish around in there and pull it out. Why don't I ever orgasm during sex? What can I do? So you can try, like, different positions, as well as I mentioned before. Most women, I think it's like 80-something% of women, do not have an orgasm just on penetration alone. You need some other kind of stimulation. So I mentioned in my period video that the clitoris is for pleasure. A little part is on the outside, but a huge chunk of the clitoris is also on the inside. It actually wraps around the vagina. Also, if you just want to, like, use your fingers and rub the clitoris, or you can get, like, a vibrator, because using the fingers is a lot of work. What is queefing? So queefing is just like when air is getting in there as he's penetrating. It's not a big deal. It kind of sounds like a fart, but it's not. And if you guys are mature, it's not a big deal. I mean... it happens. Is it normal to get really wet during sex? Yes, that's absolutely nothing wrong with that. The more, the better. Honestly, the more wet you are, the less it's gonna hurt. What is squirting? So squirting is clear liquid that comes out of your urethra, which is like your pee hole. I guess you would call it, like, the best female orgasm you can ever get. You don't need to squirt to have an orgasm, but it is just like the G-spot simulation. So if you don't know what a G-spot is, or if you don't know where it is, okay, so this is your vagina. Now everyone is different. Okay, so if you go in inside, right, and if you curl up, see how I'm like curling a little bit, and if you just like tap like that, that's your G-spot.
That's not a bad thing. It's okay. Don't worry. It'll be fine.
Curved penises. So everyone is different, whether it's curved or straight or circumcised or uncircumcised. Circumcised means that they pulled the skin back when they were a baby and cut the top off. Uncircumcised means that they literally just came out of mama and that's it. Nothing happened. Being sore the next day. Totally normal. Just depends on the pace and the roughness. Like if you guys were really vigorous, then you might have some pain, some aches down there. You might even bleed a little, but it's probably not that big of a deal. If you like it like that, cool. I would recommend just giving yourself time to heal a little bit before you start doing it again. Can you avoid being pregnant by washing your vagina? No. So this is obviously where like a birth control pill or birth control would be fantastic, other than condoms. The other option really is Plan B. Now Plan B is not like a birth control pill. Plan B is literally like an emergency contraceptive, which it's like one or two pills. They're like $50 or so, and you take it in situations like this. But if this is happening often for you, like if you need to be taking Plan B a lot, it's not good for you. So I would recommend actually getting on a real birth control. If I'm on birth control and take a pregnancy test, will the results work properly? Yes, they are two different hormones. They're not related, so you will have no problem with. If I'm on the pill and the guy ejaculates inside me, does that mean I won't get pregnant? So if you're taking it properly and correctly, then you shouldn't have a problem, but it's still not 100%, so just keep that in mind. Also, with any kind of birth control, you should still be using a condom to prevent against STDs. Is there such a thing as a woman condoms? Yes, I've never used one. Is it true that a woman can get pregnant from swallowing sperm? No. Pulls out before ejaculating, does that mean I won't get pregnant? So even if he doesn't ejaculate inside of you, doesn't mean that nothing came out. I'm on pills, we use condoms, and I still make him pull out. Can love protect me from getting an STD? Unfortunately, no. It doesn't matter how much you love a person or anything like that. If they have it and they don't tell you and you don't use protection, then you got it. If I'm on the pill, does that mean I won't get an STD? The pill does not protect against STDs. And that's it, you guys. That is all the questions that I have. And again, please, please let me know what I've missed and other questions down below. I will most definitely do a part two if you need me to. I'm down for it. So like this video if you enjoyed. Like this video if it helped you. Leave a comment down below. Yep. Anyways, thank you so much for watching, and I will catch you in my next video. Toodles!